So I will show you a presentation about the way we work in France, focusing the paradigm shift, which is how to incorporate a risk concept into the forecast department, how this risk concept has been integrated, adopted by forecaster, by Météo France, and how communicating IBF to society. It will be explained with the example of the French system, the vigilance experience, and that will be all that concepts will be explained, mainly explaining our way to work on IBF. So if you apologize at first. Intento de hablar en español.
I try to speak Spanish. It's a true shame not to speak more Spanish. I can understand a little bit, but I cannot speak a lot.
My English is better, but it's not really perfect. I can't do that in French. I'm sorry. So sorry for my French accent, and if I mix a little bit of English, Spanish, and French. And thanks and good luck to the translator. So, first of all, only one definition. Vigilance is the French word that's meaning both awareness and carefulness, or caution. It will be translated by watchfulness, depending on the case. But vigilance is okay. I think the word in Spanish, vigilancia, is it's the same for you. So small outlines of the presentations. How to communicate about risk generated by meteorological events, and not only about meteorological forecast. Why and how? First of all, I must apologize to with Jones and James, because the term of risk has not a very scientific definition in that presentation. And but you'll surely understand. So why and how communicate about risk, about IBF, and not only meteorological forecast? I will explain the genesis of the vigilance system, the presentation of the system in details, how it had been adopted, and how it is used by forecaster very concretely, and how impacts are communicated to society. First of all, a little show of French organization all over the world. Météo France is the operator of the French government as regards people and good meteorological safety. And one of our missions is to meet the needs of civil protection and risk prevention authorities. It's written in law, it's written, it's a mission we have it's important that it's a need that has been explained by the government. So we have territories all over the world, and there is people of Météo France all over the world. So that we are a lot of people. We are 3,000 persons. I'm sorry. I understand that it's not easy for main meteorological service to have an important amount of people. Main persons are located in Toulouse, in the south of France. It's around 1,000 persons, with researchers, School of Meteorology, technical support. All the meteorological, all the forecasters and all the personnel in Météo France have studies here in Toulouse. So we are 3,000, but we are a big family. We almost know each other. And we have 7 regions area. I work here in Lyon, and in each regional center, you have around one. I mixed it. Not. We have 100 persons. And the rest is on overseas territories. We have three levels, national levels. In France, it's around 500, and I don't know how to say perfectly the number. You see, square kilometers. And at the regional levels, it's around 10 to 20 departments. And the department, when I told about local level, it's a department. A department, it's around 75 kilometers. It's okay? So that you can understand the scale we use to make our forecast. We used to have one center in each department 10 years before, but now they are almost all closed. And we have still this regional level that make forecasts for all the areas, with a few small centers in some departments. So we still have local contacts that are still important to the feedback of what happened at local level. That's the radar networks. I think we have one more just now here, and here it's mountains. It's difficult to have radar, so we guess what's happened in mountains, but it's not easy to be sure. And we try to set small radar in mountains with small band X radar that are shorter, have a shorter range, but they're okay to see. And we integrate all those data to have a good way to see how rains are located. And we have, of course, numerical weather products models. The main model is a global model Arpège, which runs to 5 days. We use a lot the UCMWF models. We look at all the other weekend, but mainly the French one, the UCMWF models. And we have a very local fine resolution 1 kilometer model, which is named AROM, which forecasts are up to 36 to 42 hours. It's really shape, and it's really like it a lot. And as many forecast center, we are ongoing evolution for operational ensemble prediction with AROM and with the global model. So we use more and more ensemble products. So as you told that often it's not easy for you to make understand to your government that it's important to invest in meteorology, I just had yesterday that slide, which is what benefit for society to make meteorological forecast. So that's the result. Sorry if it's French, because I had it yesterday. It's the result of studies that try to calculate the rate benefit cost of meteorology. It's a little bit complicated. They calculate for all that part of the society, plain agriculture, general public, security services, transport. The way they calculate benefit is a little bit complicated, but they calculate that including at least 1 to 2.5 billion euros is almost the same than American dollars per year, the benefit society economic data are 4 to 8 times higher than the annual budget of the establishment. So it's worth really to invest in meteorology. For UCAMEMO, it's even more. It's the benefit cost rate is estimated at 12 to 14. John is not here anymore. So So I don't know if you can I say to your government, to your partnerships, that it's really important to invest in meteorology to make the meteorologic service grow up, but it's really benefit for society. So the genesis of the vigilance systems before, it's around before 2000. We used to emit We used to write warnings, like it's written in every country, and they were for civil protection authorities mainly, which in turn were in charge of warning the general public, and organize the aid to victims. It was made according to meteorological threshold, locally defined according to local use. For example, in an area you use mean winds, another you use only gusts. For rainfall, what do you use? Total rainfall, instantaneous intensity. It was not normalized. And as usual, in your warning, you describe the area impacted, the meteorological parameters, the situation, the duration of the events, and the value forecast to be reached. And either you are local authorities or population, what does it mean, that built-ins? If you don't know exactly what means 100 millimeters of rainfall during 6 hours or 3 centimeters of snow per hour, if you don't know what does it physically means, what are the results, what do you understand with this message? It's really exceptional, it's dangerous, is it dangerous? What will be the consequences? And what do you have to do? We are talking about that in 5 days, so I think you're already convinced. So then came two important major storms in 1999, between Christmas and New Year's Eve. And we had an important rate, almost 100 fatalities and very, very huge damage in forests and infrastructures, more than 15 billion euros of damage. And what was the problem is that the forecast was enormously good, but we realized that there were poor efficiency in the warning process and poor understanding both from the public and the authorities. So the prime ministers decide to update the warning procedures. This point is a little bit important because it's a political will. It didn't came only from the meteorological service. It came from politicians at the higher level of the states. And civil protection authorities were in that same way of thinking. So they had an implementation of the laws and civil protections and Météo France proposed together a more simple and updated system with simple and updated colors. We try to make the message to be the most simple possible to be understood by people. And the other point, very important, it was decided to inform general public and authorities at the same time, simultaneously. Not only inform public authorities and then wait for them to inform the general public. It was decided to inform them both together. Oh, just a few photos of the tempest. So it was around in 2000, and according to a proposition made simultaneously by Météo France and civil protection authorities, we elaborate the system, which was inspired by what happened in French overseas territories, which are very used to cyclones, hurricanes. So they already have a risk culture and they already know how to warn very quickly population because they have a tropical cyclone every 2 years. So they know, they have the system simple with color, and they know how to warn quickly population. So the similar, it's simple with colors, and we introduce advices, and again, same message at the same moment to population and authorities. And with few differences, in the vigilance map you will see, the color indicates the intensity of the phenomenon, the intensity that the phenomenon will reach during the next 24 hours. In the hurricane alert system, the color indicates the chronology. For example, when you are in orange, the hurricane is forecast to strike within the next 24 hours. When you are in red, within the next 3 hours, that means leave your work, go to your home. So, how does it work? We have four colors. We have nine hazards. We have the summer hazards here that include heat waves, and the winter hazards that are not the same, that includes cold waves and avalanches. This is the first page of the website. When you come on the website of Météo France, you, in one click, you arrive to this map. When each time you have the red or orange, what is important is the red orange level. When you have the orange level, it's important. Before, when it's yellow, it's not so important. Civil protection doesn't make anything. When you reach the orange level, civil protection are prepared to have damage, and they know they will need to have to have more persons, and they call persons and say don't go to sleep. No, they prepare their needs in persons. So we communicate mainly when it's orange, and when it's orange, the main hazard symbol is shown. And you are here. You have here advice that are automatically written depending on the hazard, and it's already displayed on the map. This map is broadcast and updated daily on internet, at least twice a day at 6 a.m. and 4 p.m. Those regular hours are important because media needs to know at what time do they have to look at this map. We do it every time at the same hours, at the beginning of the day, before people go to work, and at the end of the afternoon, before the night TV news, the evening TV news. That's a journalist, a media needs to have regular hours. And of course, when it's orange or red, it's updating if necessary. So that's more than 6 and 4 hours that's updated even at when it's orange or red. It's another type of presentation. I won't show you these presentations. Okay. So what hazards are described by the vigilance, and what level of risk? Those nine weather hazards. What have to be said that at the beginning it was really less, and new hazards have been added. Each time the system shown it was insufficient for good communication. For example, in 2003 we had a big heat waves. with an estimation of 50,000 fatalities due to these heat waves. So we implemented the system, and we had one year after we had heat waves and cold spells. Where are they? Yeah. Heat waves and cold spells hazards. I must say that we follow avalanches too, that needs to have many people in mountains to make measures. I'm not sure that. Do some of you try to forecast avalanches? No? Is there a warning system for avalanches? It's a little bit complicated because you need people to be in mountains to measure the snow, and you need to have a lot of people. It's a really an interesting part of the job, but made by really specialists. I can't do that job. So the level of risk, green. No particular awareness of the weather is required. You can do what you want with the weather. Yellow, be attentive if you intend to practice activities exposed to meteorological risks. That means that people are responsible for their own security. And when you have the orange level, be very vigilant. It's the level where it's the real step for a special organization in civil protection. So you don't have to make orange level very often to be trustable, to be credible. And red, it's very exceptional. I'm a forecaster since... In Lyon, I'm forecaster since 10 years, and I've never went to red level with snow. We have to be... It must be very, very, very rare. So when you click, at the time you have an orange level, when you click on the department, you can follow you can follow the time of the event. So you have the schedule that is forecast with this event, if you want to have details. And then you have the built-ins. And what is important is that in addition of the forecast itself, for orange and red level only, you have the potential impacts that are systematically described in warning and text bulletins. And is it a problem for the forecasters? No, because the works have already been done before. It's automatically included in the bulletin, so the forecaster only decides the level of the alert, and automatically, when you have decided the hazard and the level of the alert, the potential impact are included. It's not complicated for the forecaster, and those wordings of potential impact have been collaborated by civil protection, but that point is important. You have to meet together to describe all the potential impacts. So civil protection, Minister of Ecology, Minister of Health, Transport, Hydrology, Seas, etc. Have written those wordings as potential impacts together. For example, what can be described impact? You can describe try to describe description. And also, you have advice based on the same way of advice for people. Systematically provided with a summary on the national map itself, and with full information in the orange and text warnings. In the same way, they are collaborated with our partners, and they appear as official advice from public authorities. So at the same, it's not written by the forecasters, it's doing before. Example of advice, prepare emergency lightning means and have supplies of drinking water in case of flood. So our system has been adopted by forecaster, but it wasn't so. It's important to define before clearly each responsibility within the NMHAs and with other government authorities such as civil protection. So before, we have to write an official interministerial circular that defined what everybody has to do very clearly. And concretely, an easy to use and adapted IBF interface software that allows the forecaster to do his job. In fact, the job of the forecaster didn't really change. That is, make the meteorological forecast and warn when critical thresholds are reached or overpassed, and where and for how long times. It's what you do, everybody. And then you use the software that I will show you now. I show you the software we use. So we have an interactive software. We have the main national center here and 7 areas with forecaster in all those areas. That means 12 users that working together at the same moment. So here it's the national senior forecaster. It's not everybody, but it's shift jobs. We have people all the day and all the night in the national center, but also in regions. So the national forecaster says the main, it's around 10 persons for the national forecaster, plus a lot of other people for seas, for planes. We have 7 chief regional forecaster in the regions. And the propositions of the IBF color, the IBF color is made at the regional levels. And they need to be accepted by this level, by the national levels. We have 2 avalanches mountain center, one here in the Alps and one here in the Pyrenees. And many local snow specialists on the ground. And the CHAPI, it's for river watching. It's another department. It's not Météo France, but we work with them on the same tool. So how does it present? It's easy. You have all the hazards here. You choose one, thunderstorm, snow, rainfall, and floods. Rainfall and floods are together. Avalanches, heat waves, wind. And here it's floods only. That means floods without rainfall. It was used, we needed to make the difference because if you want to interrupt to ask a question, and don't hesitate. So we choose the parameters, and here we click for the next 24 hours for with the color. And here is all the departments we are responsible for. So it's in my area here in the center east of France. And I have all those departments. That's the area location. You choose the area location that is already defined. and you choose the schedule of your hazard. It's okay. And for example, if you want to put all those departments at the orange level, you make your choice, and this choice has to be accepted by the national levels, which is warrant for the consistency. The consistency of the national map, because before being available, it has to be accepted by the national levels. But it takes only a few seconds. You work your proposition, and the national level accept in a few seconds, usually. Or if there is a problem of disagreement, it has to be discussed. But usually, the expert level, it's at the regional levels. At the national levels, we have discussion, and they are warrant of the consistency, not to have to have a consistency map. It's nice to have a beautiful map. We have without having orange department spotted, scattered everywhere. After acceptation, the regional forecaster can write its warnings. And I must say that even if the responsibility of the color choice is individual, in fact, it's really a teamwork that is the result of many discussions, many exchanges of views at every level, at the national levels, at the local levels, at the regional levels. And how is it done? Is it done by two conference calls each day at 9 and 21 hours. So at the beginning of the day, but not totally the beginning, once you have understood the situation. And at the beginning of the night, but after 1 or 2 hours of works, when you have understood the situation. Don't two conference calls each day between the regional and the national levels. So that means around 10 participants. We all speak together, and we have agreement about the situation. And also two conference calls very early in the morning and early in the afternoon between the regional and the local levels. The local levels that still exist, because there is few local levels. And of course, when it's orange or red, we have non-regular conference during all the day. What looks like a warning bulletin? When you have done that, you click here. That means I want to write my bulletins. And you come to that. And you just have to fill those empty space. So what is automatically in the bulletins? The type of the type of danger, here it's thunderstorm. When it is expected to begin and when it is expected to end. So you write your bulletin long time before, if it's possible. And you precise the beginning of the events. The end of the event, you will be able to change it after. This bulletin is written every 3 hours at or less if you don't have something to change in your forecast. Alors, here you have the impacted area. That's all the departments that are impacted. The qualification of the events. Alors, here it's a little bit important because it's where you put in a very short description. If you want something to read only one thing. It's the qualifications of the events. For example, it's a short description which are, for example, very strong storm that looks like the 1099 ones. So people can compare to something very concrete they know. Another example of event qualifications, you can say is event not exceptional that occurs in autumn 2 or 3 times a year, but worrying due to last rainfalls and river states. So you have a lot of propositions that are already written and you can choose in. You don't have to think too much. If you have nothing in the proposition automatic that are made, you can change the way it's written. But it's a work that the forecaster don't need to do. It's already done before. You have a very big choice of it's an input help for reduction with many, many examples that can be used among a large choice. That work has to be done before by a team. Because you have to write your built-in very quickly. You have to you don't have time to think too much. And you have a help for reduction. For example, wind gust, some values and what adjective you can use to qualify them. It's to have an almost common language. And here in the observed data, you understand what is it, what is the situation for the moment. And forecast evolution, that's what you all do. You explain with not too complicated words the situation. And the consequences, the possible consequences and advice are added automatically according to the type of hazards you have chosen and the color. It's automatic. And it looks like that at the end. So I don't train. I told you that already. So the bulletin is issued at the regional level, and you also have ones that it's made at the national levels for the same situation, because with one situation you can have a thunderstorm in all that area. So this region write one bulletin, this region write bulletin, and at the national level it tried to resume the situation. So adoption of the system by forecaster. In fact, the main job of the forecaster remains to elaborate meteorological forecast, and the potential consequences and advice are automatically defined, so you don't have to write them. It decides the warning colors according to meteorological threshold. So we have told about those thresholds, which are an aid for decision. It's important to say that it's an help for decision for the forecaster, and they can be adapted, modulated in specific situation. And the threshold depends on the area. They can be modified from a year to another. That's why I don't know in your situation, but the meteorological thresholds are rather confidential. They don't need to be communicated to media and population. When you are in orange, you have a journalist that calls you. You don't say, we are in orange because we have passed over the 100 kilometer threshold. It can be less, in fact. You don't talk to media and journalists about those thresholds. That they are intern. They can change. The decision has to be taken at, if possible, regional level by a forecaster which is with a shift jobs. the events can occur at night, so you need to have people at night. Oh, well, yeah. For missed event, it means something you didn't see very well, and it's still possible to make a very late warning. And the decision is sometimes very rapid without needing a chief authorizations. Sometimes when you have a very big thunderstorm that occurs, you can understand it's important. You sometimes have only a few minutes to decide to push the orange button. So it must be a decision that can be taken rapidly without calling your chief. It's orange. Do I need to am I authorized to push the orange button? Sometimes it's very quick, and it's important to even if you miss the event, even if the forecast is missed, it happens often. It's important to show that you have saw the event, even if it's late. And this IBF system, I mean, it's very gratifying and valuing challenge for National Meteorological Service. You know you're very useful when you do that job. And it's important also for the forecasters to explain the forecast or what should happen with very simple terms and make it accessible to non-scientist people. So setting an ongoing life of the system. At the beginning, so it was in 2001, there were initial training for forecaster that explained how to use the software, how to define the threshold, their modulation. This tape of defining the threshold is important. I don't know if we will be able to come back on how to define threshold locally, but threshold, I can have a few words. At the beginning, threshold can be proposed only with climatological value. You can try to first define your threshold, saying I don't want an event that occurs. I want to have a threshold for an event that occurs only one time every 2 years, or one time every 10 years. For red level, for example, a threshold of one time every 10 years can be a good idea. For orange, one time every 2 years can be a good start. And after you adjust with, in reality, you compare, each time you have an event, you compare what was the values you measured, and what was the damages. So it's a constant evolution with the thresholds. They are almost rewritten. At the beginning, there was rewritten almost every 1 year. No, it doesn't move too much, and they are rewriting really less. And among possible training for forecaster, we have a lot of meeting of forecaster together in the regional area and national area. Each year we meet together, we discuss about meteorological situation and the system. And we had also have training to training course, so how to answer to media, how to write clearly to understand an understanding a bulletin, easy to understand, how to communicate. Most of us are at the beginning scientists and not often ready to communicate simply with population. We have really know how to speak simply, to have a clear message, to be understood. And with workshops, many return of experience, that mean each time you have a specific meteorological situation, we try to have feedback and to understand why the forecasts were good, or mainly why it was not good. We prefer to discuss about missed event. Rapidly, how to communicate about the vigilance system with media and population. At the beginning, at the launch of the system, we did many press media conference. It's very important at the beginning of the launch of the systems and regularly after. I think one time every 2 or 3 years we invite journalists to explain again and again and again the system. Now is mainly well known, and it's done both by Meteo France and all the partners, civil security, etc. And we invite many after media conferences and press conferences. There are a lot of reports on radio, on TV. It's also good to make well-documented exploitations on the meteorological websites and on the partners' civil protection website. You can still edit brochure prospectus with paper. I know it's a little bit old, and now we use mainly our smartphones, but it's not unuseful to still have some papers that you can distribute in tourism offices or in hospitals, schools, or in city halls. And we can also have, if the system is sufficiently efficient to be communicated about, we can also make advertising campaigns to communicate about the system at the beginning of the systems. Oh, I pass a little bit rapidly here. It's what have been done by civil protection communication. Civil protection for each hazard. Oh, it's in French, sorry again. Each hazard, here it's heavy rainfall, floods, strong winds. On each hazard, for orange and red color, they write all the advice of what you have to do. It's written a little bit small. So, for example, I can try to translate you some words. Strong winds, orange, strong wind. Stop every activities, out activities. Stop sports when you are outside. Don't, I'm sorry, I can't translate everything. So it's for each hazard, for thunderstorms, snow and ice, floods only. Cold spell, heat waves and avalanches. You have all the advice. Our communication partners, the institutional framework, in fact, it's the secret of an efficiency of the systems. These are all the partnership, the governmental partnerships, which have participated to the definition of the system. So you have, of course, civil security, civil protection, which is one part of the Interior Ministry. You have the Environment, Energy and Sea Ministry. Here you have Road Security, Health Ministry, and the French Navy. And the first step, and maybe one of the most important before creating an IBF warning system, it's to define the good partner and to have good relationships with them. So it's really the first and the most important step, I think. It's find the good partners, find the good person to communicate with, and to have to define this system together. So a few words about the organization of civil protection. You have every level of the civil protection. You have very local level, that means town level, village level, department level, regional levels, and after national and Europeans. That are all the supports you have for the civil protection organization. And at each level, they have someone to communicate with in the Météo France, okay, in the Météo France, in the meteorological center. I pass a little bit quickly. That is where I wanted to go. So you have for each partner, you have Météo France here, the general management, very general management, operational national level, operational regional level, and operational local level. And for each level, you have someone to communicate with with the other partners. So you have a communication on that level, from the up to the bottom, and on the transversal level with our partner. So with civil protection, at the national level, they communicate with the national center. At the regional level, you communicate with the regional center. Because if you don't have those levels, the person hears that will be on in operational civil protection won't know with who talk about, with who they will be able to talk. Here it's the Météo France center. When you emit your bulletins, it goes directly on the internet, on Twitter, on mobile phone application. You still have a number you can call to have the to have the forecast, but it's less and less used. And to media, TV, and radio, it all goes to those partner, not partner, those directly. And in case of orange and red vigilance, it's broadcast on the main national channels and radio, and often at the beginning of TV news. And often experts from Météo France can be invited to talk at TV news. So you don't have to be afraid to talk and being interviewed. And at the same moment, it goes to the civil protection, to the sea ministry, environment ministry, road securities, and health ministry. That's for heat waves and for cold waves. And the civil protection alerts the town level. Here it's an example of how TV news open their show. It's an important map. When you have orange, it's the media. Don't hesitate to use it and to broadcast it very, very, very largely. So different media, smartphone, Twitter, of course, we can do without, and it will be the future. It's not, it's already. So on the first, on the application of Météo France, on the first open page, you instantly, oops, immediately, you immediately have the color of the vigilance at the place where you are. And this map is already at the first page. You don't have to search a long time to find it. Five. I already told you about the organization, so I can pass through that. Here also, it's a multi-expert process. I already told you about, so I repeat. The national forecaster in Toulouse, two conference calls each day with the regional forecasters. Here it's small pictures of the national center. Very big operation center. It's a rather old photo. It don't like looks like that again. And when you have the color decision, only when it's red. When it's red, you have a management for out of routine situation. When it's red, it's almost a ministerial level. It's almost a decision of the ministry. Météo France makes a proposition of red, but you have to discuss with the ministry. It has to be, when it's red, it's really important. It's not a decision easy to take. The orange decision, it's easy to take, but with a heavy consequences, but the red decision, you don't take it without asking to the ministry, to the not the first ministry, but almost. Okay, and for the end, just a few examples of what are our thresholds. In fact, it's really more and more complicated. But for the yellow criteria, for example, for strong winds, heavy rainfalls, thunderstorm, avalanches, snow and ice. For strong winds, when it's orange, it depends. It's for gusts in plains from 70 to 100 kilometers per hour. For orange, it's when it's more than 100 and 130. It depends really on the area. In fact, it's there is some regions where when you have specific areas that are used to strongest winds, the thresholds are not the same. For heavy rainfalls, it's very different from a place to another. For example, in the west of France, 20 to 40 millimeters in a day, it's a lot. In my area, when I see 20 to 40 millimeters, that means almost no consequences for us. You have to, if you will have consequences, if you have more than 100 millimeters. So the yellow threshold are rather frequent. There is a lot of yellow on the map, almost all the years long. It has to be, you know, that the important step is orange, only orange. For thunderstorm, it's complicated. I don't know no country where thunderstorm thresholds are easy to define. And we have not only threshold, meteorological threshold, we have, of course, a lot of other criteria, which is the forecast reliability, the durations of the events, simultaneously different hazards or decolligation, and what I wanted to tell you about is that you can modify by your own the threshold. Depending of the day or time schedules of the event, if it's weekend, holidays, then traffic hours. If it occurs with not used population, for example, during the winter, if you have snow and you know that you have all the people of the capital that are in mountains and they are not used to have snow on the road and they don't know how to drive on snow, you will lower your threshold. Sorry. If the hazards occurs in the youth district or not, so that's the same. In urbanized city areas, altitudes of highways are important. Of course, the hydrological background or snow melts. So you will have, if there is few rainfall and if the river are already totally plain. you will lower your threshold. If the events come early in the season or lateness, so people are not used to, it's surprising. If you have leaves on the tree, for example, if you have leaves on the tree and you have and you have winds, the damage won't be will be very different. Because the trees are heavier, and if you have leaves on the tree and rain falls, it will won't be able to go in the. I'm sure you understand. It will. Comment dit, boucher les égouts. Okay. So we try to anticipate impact, not with a model like UKIMO did, with very perfection systems. I'm very impressed by the UKIMO job, but we do it with hands. What I wanted to show is that our system is only available for the next 24 hours. What do we do after? Because we often know that we have a probability to have orange or red a long time before, but we are not sure. So we don't communicate that, not still, to the general public. We make a forecast map of probability of having orange or red warning on the area, but we communicate it only for civil protection and health ministry. And that was shown many times before by, I think it's, the Meteo Alarm, it's the public website which is exists since 2007, which is shows all the vigilance system in Europe. It's a very good system, but it has small defaults because, of course, it's not the same signification of the color between every countries. So of course every country keeps in its own criteria, but for example in Italy, yeah, they use colors every often. it's always in yellow, very often in orange or red, and in United Kingdom, it's totally the opposite. You know that when you will have a color, it's really important. They are often in red. You confirm? We don't have the same signification of colors in each country. So you have to look at it often to understand, to make your own your own understanding of the really importance of the color. In France, it's orange. I think in Italy it's red or more. And I think in United Kingdom, when it's yellow, it's important already. So I think I will end with that. I won't speak. Okay, it's finished. Do you have a few questions? I can try. Thank you.